Oh, thank you. Yeah, I actually just came from Thailand this Tuesday. The last Tuesday that just passed, I was over there for like about a week. I had to cut my vacation short because everybody was getting stuck, so I didn't want to go get stuck over there.
No, of course.
And and I wanted to, like, there's such a staunch difference between the way the rest of the world, at least in Asia, is handling this crisis. Over there, they had like checks as soon as you got to the airport. They had checks as soon as you got off, before you got actually out of the airport, in the supermarkets, and the malls. And here, when I came back, like they didn't even ask you. Like as soon as I got to the Dulles Airport, they didn't even ask you if you were feeling well. They didn't check your temperature, and people were just going out. And there was like about two, three people that were coughing like crazy on the airplane back to the States. And I'm just very surprised. And also like supermarkets, they don't do any checks. And I feel like that kind of sets a narrative where a lot of people here in the States are very hubris, because I'm seeing a lot of people at the parks, very close to each other, not even 6 feet apart. So it's kind of insane, it's
Yeah.
like what's going
Well, I'll
on,
tell you what,
why?
Nestor, never mind Thailand, which isn't badly affected, we are still receiving flights into Britain right now, this evening, from Iran, Italy, Spain, China, places where the coronavirus crisis has torn the population apart. You can still get on a plane in those places. You'll still fly in here. You will still not be tested. You will still not be isolated. I mean, but they've got drones hovering over moorland looking at a couple out for a walk for their exercise and criticizing them. They are buzzing people in Shepherd's Bush for sitting together on the grass. But you can still fly in from Spain, Italy, or Iran, and are doing so right this minute without anyone even asking you how you're feeling. Nestor, thanks for that call.